My name is Cassandra.
And I'm Matt.
And we are Runaway Lady May.
This is our 2008 Ford E450 6.0 diesel shuttle bus, and we've been living in her for about a year.
So let's go check her out.
So one of the first outside modifications we made to the bus was we wanted a little extra storage, so we got a truck toolbox. We mounted it into the front frame of the bus, got that custom welded, mounted it on, and that's where we store some extra supplies. Let's go check it out. So when we open her up, you'll see we keep our Weber grill in here. We have an emergency generator just in case something goes funky with our solar. We have extra engine oil, a torque wrench, gas can for the generator. Just some of our extra supplies that are good to keep outside. This bus was originally a city shuttle bus, so it actually had a bike rack on the front of it. What we were able to do was pull off just the bike rack, but still use the way that it mounted into the bus to retrofit that for the storage.
All right, so guys, let's talk about the paint. I used a lot of paint. I used the Rust-Oleum metal oil-based paint. Okay, so I sanded down the entire bus as much as I could until my hands were like about to bleed. And then layer after layer, I painted this entire beauty. And our theme was kind of like a retro.
Like old station wagon kind of.
Yeah, like an old station wagon was our inspiration for the whole outside.
And fun fact, when we first started putting on the brown, it was darker than we wanted it to be, so we actually mixed some white paint in with it. The best part about that is we were able to reenact it for the layers preceding, but now we never can, so if we ever need to touch up that paint, it's gonna be really hard to match it.
But she's still beautiful nonetheless.
Absolutely.
And we actually ended up rolling the paint. Tiny layers with a lot of paint thinner to make it as thin as possible and as many coats as you can as possible is the key to rolling it.
Yeah, the paint thinner really, really helps not have bubbles in the layers that you're putting on.
Yeah.
All right, so now at the back of the bus, we have another custom addition that we added on. We got a back rack welded on the back. We actually flat tow a Jeep Wrangler behind our bus, so this was super important to have it a strong, sturdy system. It's actually welded into the frame of the bus. On top of the back rack, we leveraged it for a little bit of extra storage. We have our propane tanks, and we also have this little container that we use for some extra storage.
Yep, so in here we just store some firewood, our camping chairs, our propane grill for outside, and just some extra things to, you always need extra storage in buses, right? For our ladder, we didn't do a fixed ladder. We actually did it where we could clip it in from the bottom and up to the top. All right, so this is just a kid's ladder, like a playground kid's ladder off of Amazon for like 20 bucks, I think we bought it. To be honest, it works great for us, and we like the fact that you can take it off and put it back on.
So up here we have our solar panels. We have three Grape Solar 175 watt mono solar panels. So total of 525 watts of solar on our roof. This suits us fantastically. And there we have the entry gland that brings us down into our bus batteries. So here we are up on our deck,
which is our favorite thing in our build.
It's about a 8x8 build. We really wanted to have like an outdoor patio that we could get a different perspective of the areas that we're staying in. So I built this all out of wood. It's actually up on 2 2x4s with brackets that use screws that anchor in to the beams of the roof of our bus. So this thing's on here very sturdy. There's 6 total brackets, I believe, mounted into a total of 3 beams that the deck overlaps with. And we just use some 1x3s to deck the top of it. And
some stain, like the outdoor stain on top of these so they don't get bad. So a lot of people ask us when they come into our bus, where's the bathroom?
It's kind of like the most common question when you meet someone on the road is, so where do you poop?
We had a ton of extra space in our garage area, so let's show you guys.
We have an Airhead composting toilet. And when we were doing our build, we originally thought we were gonna build this in the main alleyway of our build and just have it roll out from under our sink. But then we realized we were gonna have all of this wasted space. Now this is how we access our garage, so we couldn't really build any shelving back here. That's when we decided to pivot our build and put the toilet right at the end of our bed in this wasted space. And we also mounted our outdoor shower here.
So we just hook it up usually we have a little thing that goes right there, and we're able to shower right here when it's beautiful and nice outside.
So rolling on past the toilet, we also have our garage back here. So if I open this up, this is where our water tank sits, as well as some extra stuff. We have an inflatable kayak, some extra clothing, paddles, and just a bunch of other extra junk under there.
Yeah, whatever we can fit goes under here. So the newest addition to our beautiful bus is our front door.
So we actually put a house door up on the bus. The first 3 months in the bus, we had the regular bus doors, and they were really a pain. They're not mechanical like schoolies are. They were actually electrical, and they just caused us a lot of issues. So we popped those doors out. We actually angle grinded them out and put on a house door. Now this is a regular house door from Home Depot. So cheap, you can't even buy it without the frame. So we bought the whole frame, took it off the hinges of the frame, and then mounted it on in the hole where the bus doors used to be. Now, it wasn't gonna be a perfect fit, so we had to frame it in, and we just framed it all out with 2x4s, and it worked out really nicely. We also have keyless entry. When we still had a house, this was on our old house, and we're able to go ahead and lock our door like that, and we're locked. No. Moving on from the door, we got the inside of our bus. So right here at the entryway for our bus, we have our steps. One thing you'll notice is I'm kind of sitting in a nook right here, and it doesn't align with the first step. That's because we extended the floor of our bus out so that we had a little bit of extra space. So this is all up on a platform, and when we made that extra space, we were like, hey, if you have extra space, you might as well use it. So we have a little secret storage compartment there, and you can see where the actual original bus steps were. Past that, we have a shoe rack over here and a little driving console. You'll see the driving console inside, but we just cut this out to kind of flow with the bus. It gives us the most storage without cutting into your entryway into the bus. Keep all our shoes here. There's a couple of bottle holders or cup holders for when I'm driving. And yeah, that just about covers the entryway to our bus.
Coming over into our dash, my least favorite part of the bus, I hated looking up front and seeing that like gross gray bus. So I basically taped all of the window off and I spray painted it this nice, like beautiful, creamy color just to kind of lighten it up, because one thing we wanted in our build was a lot of color and very just bright and lively. And also this area allows us to store all of Matt's rocks that he collects and just some of our little knickknacks, because we like still having knickknacks even living in a tiny space. So in our build, we wanted to have somewhere to document our travels. So stickers were a really big part for us, and we built this little board and put all of our stickers for the different places that we travel. So no matter what rig we're ever in, this will come with us. And then it also just doubles as some extra storage, because in the shuttles you have that bubble cap. So we just put a bunch of miscellaneous things up there, and there's actually a ton of storage up there. Right here is the beginning to our kitchen. Up here, we like to call our pantry. It's actually super deep. It goes back all the way to the end of the bus, and we keep all of our like dried food up here. Then we have our Berkey, which we love. It is our water filtration system. So no matter where we're pulling water from, we're able to filter it properly. Even in our kitchen, we have some clothing storage. This is where Matt keeps his pants, and then I keep all of my bottoms here. And then moving down to the fridge, back to that lively color was really big important to me. So I actually sanded down the fridge and spray painted it orange. And it's actually a decent fridge, just an RV fridge, but it works very, very good for us. And then our last little gem of this is actually our can opener, which we've carried from apartment to house. And it's like this old vintage cool can opener that it just makes our little home. This area is just our little extra storage. Put all of our backpacks that we go hiking hung up here. The more hangers that you can have in a bus, the better. We keep our animals stuff all here, so it's all in one place. And then we just actually keep the animals' food and then the litter box down here for our cat.
So continuing on with the kitchen, we'll start at our stove. Like Cass has been talking about, of a pop of color. She found this, I think, on Facebook Marketplace, and it's a 1960s vintage camper stove. It was pulled out of an old Airstream, actually, and we absolutely loved it, so we ran out to North Georgia, picked it up. I had to fix her up a little bit, but she works great. It's just light with a lighter, but other than that, we love it. It's a three burner, and we have the oven portion, which during the winter time we use a lot for baking muffins, lasagnas, things like that. Continuing down, we have our counter space. So this is live edge wood here. This is poplar, which a neat little thing about this is that we're from Tennessee, and poplar is a state tree of Tennessee, so it was a nice little addition there. Here we have this little shelf that we created, not just to hold stuff, but really as a backboard, so when you're cutting things or put things on here, it's not gonna fall back into what we call the abyss, because if you get behind there, it's almost impossible to get it out. So that really prevents that from happening. One of the most unique parts of our build is our tool bench. This is our entire kitchen cabinetry, and it's actually just a Husky from Home Depot workbench. Now, we ended up going with this because we had one in our shed back home that was storing all of my tools during the build, and we recognized how much space it has and how much wasted space, how little wasted space there actually is. So like, this is all of our pots and pans and some additional stuff in here. Here I'll show you, this is all canned goods. And the good thing about these cabinets, they're built to hold weight, so these are very sturdy. And one of the best parts about it is when you're ready to hit the road and you want to drive, there's a lock right here. You just stick your key in, lock it, and these doors won't open up while you're driving. Continuing down from our workbench, we have our sink. So this sink is actually just a $10 or $15 stock tank from Walmart that I used a hole saw to drill out and then just mounted the drain and everything in. This drains down into just a 7-gallon gray directly below the sink with a little trap that prevents the smell from coming out of it. And we have running water right here. That's about all you get to see because water's precious in bus life. And yeah, that's our sink setup. What we really wanted was, we do a lot of cooking, so we wanted a big sink to store our dishes after a long night of cooking. Continuing on, we have one of our two spice racks. This holds some of our oils and some of our Indian spices here. And then we have two other spice racks right down here next to the stove. This is where we store a bunch of our other spices. And the last part I'll mention in the kitchen is one of our two top shelves, I'll call them. We did an open shelving with baskets, and we still have even more spices right here. Like I said, we do a lot of cooking and spices are important to us. In the baskets, each one varies by theme, so a lot of our extra electrical wires are all within one basket. So organization and storage intertwined is really key in bus life, making sure you can keep things in specific homes.
So some advice that we would give living on the road for about just over a year would be, one, to slow down. We see a lot of people burn out really quick because they don't slow travel. Obviously, everybody has their own time limits and things that they gotta do and where they gotta be, yeah. But we really, truly recommend taking your time, being in places for a month or two, enjoying them, acting like you're living there.
Yeah, I mean, some people try to hit every national park in their first 6 months on the road, and we do the opposite of that.
It's just not attainable.
We were in Montana this summer. We spent 3 whole months in Montana and still felt like that wasn't enough. One thing to know, if you're living this lifestyle, it's your life. So treat it a little more like a normal life than a constant vacation so you don't burn yourself out. I think the other big piece of advice that we would give is to try not to overreact when things go wrong. Because the reality is, you're living in a friggin' bus. You're living in this giant heavy vehicle. Like, things are gonna go wrong. And if you freak out every time you do, then you're really gonna stress and burn out. Good example of this was when we, early on in our travels, we were going up just outside of Santa Fe in Black Canyon, right? Mm-hmm. And something happened with one of our overhead shelves while I was driving and she was driving the Jeep behind, and the shelf totally collapsed, glass fell out, everything just fell all over the bus while going around a turn close to midnight in the pitch dark. And we pulled up to the campsite and I jumped out to go look around and I said, oh, by the way, the shelf fell.
She was like, well, what shelf? And I was like, you know, like everything. The one that has everything. And that was a big moment for me because a lot of times I'd overreact whenever anything went wrong. And for me in that moment, I was like, it's okay. We can clean it. We can put a new screw in. We'll fix that shelf. Let's just continue on living and just not stress out about it.
Yeah. So very much go with the flow personality and just kind of finding that zen when things tend to go wrong. That's the reality when you're living like this. So a really important part of our build was having somewhere to work that is comfortable and that is convenient. Matt works full-time on the road and I work part-time, so it was super important to us to have a nice desk space. So we actually, from our workbench in our kitchen, we took the old one, we took the top off, and we actually refurbished it to make it look kind of like rustic and edgy. And what I'm sitting on is an original bus seat that I just spray painted with vinyl spray paint to give it a little nicer of a shine, make it look a little cleaner. So this is a really, really big workspace that allows us to have multiple computers and multiple things going on at once. So coming this way, we have our couch, which is actually comes out into a full-size bed. Under the left side is all of our storage. We actually carry a portable AC unit in case it gets really hot, the animals. It's nice to have something to cool it down in here. And we actually just have a bunch of random things shoved under this left side of the bus, of the couch. And under the right side is where we have our bus batteries. So this just pulls out into a full-size bed. So if we have like friends or family coming to stay with us, it's super nice to have them here. So having insulation in a rig is super, super important. So what we decided to do was have two layers of curtains. We have these just sheer curtains that can close like this so nobody can see in, but then we also have our insulated curtains. So all you have to do is unhook them and roll them down and just tuck them behind. They have Reflectix inside, so they keep it keeps it warm in here if it's cold outside, or if it keeps it cool in here if it is warm outside. Above that is our little shelf. So again, just like the other side, we have just a bunch of little stuff. This is actually where we keep our beauty stuff. So just personal health, hygiene things kind of go up here. And then lastly is our where we put Matt's fishing rods. When we first moved into the bus, we had nowhere to put them and they were always in the way. So we just found these little clips on Amazon, boom, and they just go right to the ceiling. We both work on the road. I work part-time as a virtual personal trainer. I actually had a studio when we lived in Chattanooga, Tennessee, but with COVID, it actually allowed me to take that studio virtually. My clients were cool with it, so I went and I hit the road.
Yeah, and then for me, I actually work in tech. I work for a fully remote company called GitLab, and I just do online work full-time on the road. This is our ceiling. We actually insulated the roof with, I think, 3/4 inch, maybe a little bit more, of foam board insulation. And then we wanted to have a wood board ceiling. So this is tongue and groove 1/8 inch cedar that we mounted up. We were able to use a nail gun to mount it into the beams that go across. They have a little bit of wood underneath the steel beams. So we were able to mount right into there. And then we just stained them some sort of rustic color that I'm trying to remember, but it escapes me. Moving on from our ceiling, you'll see a lot of greenery in our bus and a lot of rope. Both of those were used to cover any gaps and cracks of our build. So right here you see, this is actually just fake greenery from Michael's that we used to kind of fill in the gaps and cracks around the emergency hatch of the bus. There's a couple other places of the bus that you'll see it. A lot of people call that out in our build and think it's a neat idea. We love it, and it was really easy rather than having to mess with any sort of molding to make it look nice. So this is our electrical cabinet. On the outside of the door, we just have this rack that we keep our books and some produce on, and right now a half finished bottle of wine. But behind the door is our entire electrical setup. Now it's a little bit of a pain to get to, so I'm not actually going to open it up, but our electrical system's pretty beefy. We have 600 amp hours AGM battery, which like Cass said is underneath the right side of the couch. Then behind here is the whole rest of the setup. 600 amp hours AGM batteries, 525 watts of solar. We have a 2000 watt inverter. We have
shore power ability. We're able to hook up to 30 amps of shore power, and we also have an alternator charger. So while the bus is running, we're able to go ahead and charge our batteries. We run everything that we can from DC that we can, and then we also have two lines of AC power running on either side of the bus, controlled by one breaker on each side.
Moving on to our bedroom, we put this just Target or Walmart, whatever, easy, cheap storage unit, one of those little cubics, and we just put it back on it so it doesn't fall through, but it just holds all of our clothes. So we don't have any upward storage or hanging storage, but this is plenty for us. Coming into our bed, we have a full-size bed. I wish it was a little bit bigger, to be honest. I wish we went with a queen, but a full-size works great for us at the time being. And over back here, we have two storage bins. More clothes. You actually need more clothes than you think on a rig, especially if you're living in different climates. So more clothes. And then over here to the right of me, we have our water heater that just hooks right up to our sink so my hands don't get freezing when I do the dishes. Again, back to the back, we have the more greenery to cover some of the back area. And under the bed, we have our diesel heater, which I highly recommend diesel heaters. They are a great source. They actually make the whole bus even, like it's not like warm at your feet and cool at your head or vice versa. It's, the whole bus is nice and warm, and all we have to do is press it right here from bed, so when we're cold we don't have to get out of bed of it being cold just yet. Back here, instead of doing the whole thing wood coming in with the tongue and groove, we actually just found this decorative piece of plywood at Home Depot, and it just bent just enough where we were able to perfectly just kind of press it up and in and get it stuck in there nice and easy. So it's a little bit different, and it actually brings some contrast to the style of the bus.
So right here we have our router. A good secure internet connection is really important for me working on the road. This router has stronger antennas than a regular cell phone, and it's basically a glorified mobile hotspot. So it's 4G LTE, it works off of AT&T's network, and it's fully unlimited. If we're somewhere that we have some service but need it a little bit stronger, we actually have an additional antenna that we can run through here and attach to the roof, and that's just a stronger WeBoost antenna, but not with the WeBoost booster. We've heard good things about it, we haven't tried it, but typically the combination of those two are enough. If you want to learn more about our internet setup and how you could get something like this, reach out to us on Instagram at runaway.ladymay.
So our build took us about 6 months. I do recommend doing it in a little bit longer. We are kind of working ourselves a little bit sick, but we had a date that we wanted to be on the road by. So I recommend doing it a little bit longer and maybe not in the dead heat of Tennessee summer.
And we were also working full time during that time. So if you're not working full time, then 6 months might be a totally obtainable goal that doesn't overstretch you. But if you are working full time, maybe decide on a year build. Yeah, like she said, it was during summer, so that was really hot. Once we completed it, we hit the road. We've been on the road for a little over a year now, and we've been absolutely loving it. Looking back at our build, if we were to change anything, I think the one thing would be
what we're sitting on currently.
Yeah.
I think we would do a dinette. And a dinette that actually turned into a couch would be our dream to do. It's nice having the space to lay down and friends and family to come visit, but we've realized that doesn't happen as often as you would like. So a dinette for us would save some space, and we wouldn't have to have the desk, and we could just have that dinette.
Yeah.
Thanks guys so much for watching our tour. I'm Casandra.
And I'm Matt, and this is our 2008 Ford E450 6.0 diesel shuttle bus that we've been calling home for just over a year now.
Yeah, make sure to follow us on Instagram at runaway.ladymay, and also over on YouTube at runawayladymay. And we'll see you guys next time.
Cheers, y'all.
Cheers.